Define the scanner. We'll need to start reading the information. So first thing that we want to read is a name. And sure, we'll have child one, child two names that we want to read. But do we need a method for that? The answer is no. In this case, the method to read the name, it's pretty simple. So we'll have child one name. And basically, based on the specification, is on the first line. So we just need to read the entire line. And this will read the child name. As you can see, we already have a method that is reading the child name, which is the next line for the scanner. So why to define a new one once we have one? So generally, we define a method if we have several things to do, a block of code that we want to execute, not just for one statement or for a couple of statements. If the code is very small and it makes no sense to define a method for it. So this is how we read the name of the first child. And in a similar matter, we'll read the name for the second child. Just being careful to use a second scanner to read the name. So we wrote the code to read the name, and then we'll have also the number of grades. And here again, is this different? Yes, it's different from each child, but to read the child one number of grades, we can again use a standard scanner method. It's already written for us. There is such a method, which is next int, next integer. So being just one line, again, doesn't make sense to create our own method to do it. We already have a method that is doing it. We just need to call it. So that's very important to decide when you need and when you don't need to create a method. And you will figure out as you gain more experience what operations are useful to represent through methods. Now we go to the grades. Now for to read the grades is not a single statement. We'll need to repeat and read several grades from each file. So it's a block of code that we'll need to define, and then we'll receive, we'll obtain as a result an array for those grades. So as you can see, we have a sequence of statements that we are needing to write for reading the grades for each of the childs from the files. Because of that, makes sense to define a method. So let's see first how we create this new method. So we like to have a method. And again, we'll start with private because for now we'll use it only in this file. And it's static because all the methods that we define are static for a given class. We'll explain later what this means. This means that can be called for this class without needing anything special. And what we'll return will be an array of ints. So what this method will do, we'll read from the file an array of grades, an array of integer numbers. And we may just say read grades, because that's what the method will do. Now, what each method will need? First of all, I need a scanner. I need to have the scanner to the file, to the place that contains these grades. So I need to have a scanner for my to be able to read from there. And second, I need to know how many grades I need to read. And we already defined the grades, but we'll need to specify it here as well. And I'll put number of grades. In general, it will be just a number of grades. And here I have read grades, but sure, you can have basically read ints, because this will work for any int, for any sequence of integers. So this will be my method. And again, to not have errors and to be able to finalize my definition, I'll just put a return null at the end for now. And let's comment this method. Read a list of grades of grades with number of grades elements from the scanner. The source or the scanner for the source of the grades, and again it may be a file in our case, but can also be the keyboard or anything else. The method will work for any kind of scanner, and this will be the number of grades read. So, and what we'll return will be an array of ints with all the grades. So that's what my method is doing, and I'm writing this because in my main program, if you go with the mouse over a method like this one that I wrote, you can see that my comments appear, and it's easy to understand what the method does without going back and forth in your program and looking at the method. Just reading this description, you will understand what your particular method is doing. That's why we write these javadoc comments to help us work with the code. It's for us and for others who are using our programs. So we clarify, we have the signature of the method. This is the signature of the method. Then we have an empty block for now, and we have the javadoc. This is like the basic description of our method. Now let's write the code. Before you call it, let's write the code to implement this method. And again, we know how many grades we have, so we need just to have a for, and here we can use an index I from 0 to the number of grades, and we go from grade to grade, we increment each time. And what we want to read the grades, but to be able to read the grades, we need to read them in an array. So we identify, okay, I need to define this array. So let's define the array grades, and I also initialize it with a new array that contains exactly the number of grades that I need to read. So this define and initialize the result, and once I have the result, I can say, okay, that's what I want to return. Not null, but this array of grades that I just created. So I have the result. Let's update the result as we go through all the elements to read from the scanner the next grade, which is an integer, so the next int from the scanner. So as you see, I have this method. I still have a warning because I didn't use it, but we'll use it in a moment. So this will allow us to get rid of this warning. But my method is just receiving the scanner a number of grades, and it's defining, initializing, reading all the elements, and then returning this new array that was read from the scanner. So in my main program now, I just need to define an array of ints, and this will be child1 grades or grade for each element. And to initialize it, instead of writing my entire description, I will just need to call this method from above, and I just want to show it to you as we do. So I just call this method readGrades, and I need to provide the parameters that the method use. So I will need to provide the scanner for child1 file, and also the number child1 number of grades. So the readGrades will know to read from the file of child1 and to read the number of grades that child1 had. And we already read that information from the file. So now we defined the grades for the first child. Similarly, what we want to do is to define the, and read and define the grades for the second child. And as you can see, it's very similar with the previous one, just that I am using the scanner for the second child and also the number of grades that the second child has, and this will give us information for the second child. Again, if we run it, we don't see anything, just that we don't have error, which is good. But we can debug it, and then we'll be able to investigate. I have a breakpoint on line 79, so it's almost at the end of the program. So debugging it will show us all the variables. And as you can see, the child, one name, John Williams. We have seven grades, and if I'm looking at the grades, are this one. And if I go here on John, are exactly the grades of John. And child two named Mary has five grades, and if I'm looking at the grades, are this one. And if I go on Mary, we can see that are exactly the grades of Mary. So our program read correctly from these two files and put in memory all of this information. What we need to do next is to continue our program with printing the grades. And again, printing will be similar, so we'll need new methods to do the printing.